Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Today I am here with the recipe of chicken dum biryani. And I know it's such a classic dish, every one of us loves to eat it. But when it comes to preparing, we all step back due to its huge process. And trust me, once you learn it, it's very easy to make. So let's check out the recipe.
First, heat the pan, add in some oil, add in 3 to 4 sliced onions, saute it until it turns crispy and brown in color. Make sure it doesn't burn and keep it aside. And then take fistful of cashew nuts, roast it until golden brown and leave it aside. Now to a mixing bowl, add in 1 kg of chicken pieces, medium sized, 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste, 6 to 8 crushed green chilies, 1 amounts of coriander and mint leaves. I have taken around 1 cup of each. 1.5 teaspoons of red chili powder, 2 teaspoons of pepper powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala, 1/4 teaspoon of cumin seed powder, salt as per your taste, 1 cup of curd, 1/2 of the fried onions. Give it a gentle mix. Add in 1 medium sized lemon juice and leftover oil which we have used to fry onions. Give it a mix and leave it aside for about 1 hour. Now heat the biryani pot or a pan or a handi. Add in 1 tablespoon of oil, 1 tablespoon of ghee, a teaspoon of caraway seeds, 1 black cardamom, 1 anise, cinnamon sticks, a bay leaf, 6 to 7 cloves, 3 cardamom. Salt it and add in the chicken, marinated chicken. Combine it well and let's cook it for about 15 minutes by covering the lid. In this process, the chicken turns soft and tender. Now meanwhile, let's cook the rice. For that, into a container, add in 5 cups of water, salt as per your taste, 2 black cardamom, bay leaves, caraway seeds, star anise, cinnamon sticks, 6 to 7 cloves, 3 cardamom, 1 tablespoon of oil and let it get a boil. Now to this, we are adding in soaked basmati rice and 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. It's the secret ingredient of this recipe. Now the chicken has cooked well. Let's place a flat griddle underneath this biryani pot so that the pieces doesn't get scorched. Check if the rice has cooked about 70% by pressing it with the help of your fingers. Drain away the rice immediately to a colander and layer it on top of the chicken. Save some rice water, we will need that. So sprinkle the rice water. Add in some ghee, a tablespoon of ghee, spread it in this way, sprinkle the fried onions and the cashews, cover it with a tight lid and place the weight on top of it, or else you can seal the container with the dough. So it takes about 20 minutes for it to cook. Now our spicy Hyderabadi chicken biryani is ready and it looks yum. And if you see, the piece has cooked very well. It's soft and tender. And Ameya is enjoying her plate of biryani. So thanks for watching. I hope you have liked the recipe. Give it a try and let me know how it is. Subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thanks for the support. See you soon with the next video. Until then, bye.